Welcome to another love reading of yours. This is for Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus. Time is fluid, guys. You could have dealt with this energy or will be dealing with in the near future. Some of the energies of the cards here can be flipped, so feel free to switch the energies, vice versa. And what else? Oh yeah, if you do need a personal reading, that information is going to be down below. You're laying off a situation that's been weighing you down, okay? You're getting rid of something. You're releasing some burden. Could be extra responsibilities, could be the responsibilities of an entire relationship, or could be something is just draining you out and you're letting it go because it's weighing too heavy on you, it's exhausting you, it's tiring you out, it's frustrating you, all right? Could be because you cut someone out, you cut out a cheater, a liar, or could just be that because you guys were just not on the same page, okay? There could be a third party situation, doesn't have to be. But I feel that there was a lack of compromise, a lack of effort, a lack of commitment, a lack of determination to work together and to build together, all right? That's what I'm getting. So yeah, I'm thinking you cut someone out, okay? You could have severed ties with someone, but whatever it was, I think there was a lack of communication again, or you could have been dealing with someone who's very manipulative or a cheater or a liar. All right, take how that resonates. Right now I feel that there is not much happening. You're just, there's someone stalking you, you're stalking them, but this is more like watching, looking, stalking, but not saying anything, okay? So they can watch you, they can spy on you, they can look at your social media, but they can't talk to you, huh? All right. And because that's the only thing that's happening, right? So it's all my, there's someone who's playing mind games, all right? Very silly. Whoever you're dealing with, that's very, someone very, very immature in communication, okay? They're just being very silly right now, okay? Mind games, someone who's very paranoid, all right? But this person thinks they know all, but they don't, all right? They don't. Let's just be clear about that. And that's the biggest, and your biggest challenge is to get a brand new beginning. But how are you going to get that brand new beginning, all right? Because there is no forward movement here, right? When the Page of Swords is in reverse, this is a lack of communication. You have the Ace of Swords in reverse at the bottom of the deck. That's another big sign of lack of communication, misinformation, whatever. But this is your biggest challenge, to start new, to start brand new, okay? And it's not going to happen till there's going to be no communication. I repeated myself 10 times, but yeah, I did. On your mind, I feel that you're giving up. You're tired of dealing with this situation, because whatever the situation is, I think it's taking a lot of courage, strength and stamina within you to pursue this, okay? To hold on to it. I think you're holding on to this relationship or this person too tight, but now you're fed up. That's why. The Ten of Wands in reverse, the Strength in reverse, okay? You're tired. You're giving up. You're throwing your hands up in the air. You're like, you know what? Screw this. I cannot do this anymore. I cannot put in all my energy into holding on to a person or a situation, which is the right thing to do, right? You can't hold on to someone. If they're meant to be in your lives, they will, right? If that person has to text you, they will. If they want to ask you out, they will. If they want to talk to you, they will. If they want to see you, they'll come see you. You don't have to keep wanting to wait for this person, okay? If it's meant for you, it'll come in, all right? What is meant for you will not pass you by. Very, very clear, all right? So you don't have to hold on so strong to someone because you want them to do things that makes you approve of them, okay? That, you know, whatever. So that's what's going on. So I think maybe after you let this relationship go, whatever this is, this person is just watching you from a distance, I'm getting. However, I feel with the High Priestess here, with the reason of the reading, I feel your intuition is on point. Maybe you feel you're trusting your intuition, you have some psychic information, you have some psychic guidance, and you're trusting your intuition probably says to let go of control issues, to surrender, to let go, okay? Your intuition says that let this go to the universe, okay? And if things have to happen, they will happen at the right time. That's what I'm getting. Because in the past, you could have been juggling a person, juggling two people, juggling a situation, or probably trying to balance out this situation, okay? Maybe work life and personal life, maybe trying to balance two different people completely, or maybe just trying to balance out this relationship, okay? But I think it was you who was trying to do both the things. Maybe this person never really contributed anywhere, all right? And now after you let this person go, you cut them off, I think now they have nothing to say. You could have been very wishy-washy, or this person could have been very wishy. I'm still getting you. You were the one who was trying to. I think you already had this in your mind for a very long time, because again, you were holding on to this for a very long time, okay? You were putting in all your strength. It could have been really draining. But it was probably on your mind for a very long time, okay? You were not being able to make a decision. You weren't getting clarity about whether you want to drop this person or not. But finally, I think with the Six of Swords here, I'm not seeing moving on. I'm seeing you getting to a better place. You're moving into calmer waters, okay? So you mentally, I think, have distanced yourself, not from this person, but distance yourself from anything that does not serve you, that does not make you happy. I'm always getting like a forced departure, okay? You were forced to do this. You didn't want to do this, but you were forced to do this, okay? And probably it was destined is what I'm getting. If this person wouldn't have done what they did with you, you would have still continued holding on to the load of this relationship, okay? It would have been a load, a burden, that you couldn't let go and you couldn't carry on, okay? But you're finally doing this. You're finally doing this, okay? You're cutting them out because this is what this person did. You were fed up. It's almost like you were fed up and you gave up on this person. It was like, I either hear what I like or that I'm cutting your head the fuck off. That's what I'm getting. Right now, I feel that with the Three of Cups and the Magician, I feel you're chilling. You're chilling. You're enjoying yourself, you have your social life. I'm not getting so much of a reconciliation. Yeah, could be a reconciliation, but I'm not getting that energy of two people together. I'm getting where you're just focusing on your life. You're focusing on what makes you happy. You're doing things that make you happy. And with a Magician here, you're in full-blown manifestation mode, okay? It's almost like you know it's coming in. You know it's coming in because your likely outcome is the Three of Wands. This is waiting and watching. You know, the Three of Wands is again more manifestation. So you are manifesting. You know why you're manifesting this, buddy? Because the Strength is in reverse. And the Ten of Wands is in reverse. And the High Priestess is here. You stopped conflicting. You stopped the conflict in your head. You became very decisive is what I'm getting. And once you let go and you surrender, right? That's exactly because this was weighing so heavy on you. It was tiring you out. And now you feel this is the right thing to do. With the High Priestess, I feel that you are very, very sure that this is the right thing to do. Okay, maybe you're not keeping, you're not talking it to this person. You're not saying this to this person. You're just like almost like a secret keeper, okay? Something very secretive and you're keeping things to yourself. But you trust your inner gut and you feel this is the right thing to do to let this burden go. Again, the burden does not always have to be the entire relationship or the person. It can just be a certain thought, a negative pattern. It can be a certain habit, anything that is weighing you down or that is weighing too heavy on you, okay? Which you feel that, you know, this is stressing you out every single time. Because the tens are completion, okay? It's not like this is a brand new relationship. Your challenge is to start a brand new beginning with this person, with the Ace of Wands here. That's your obstacle. That's your challenge here, okay? But the thing is that you're, again, I think you're, either there's one person here who after you cut them out, they're not taking action towards you. They're just watching you from a distance. Or this is just you who's just trying to gather more information, but you're still not ready to put things into action. Okay? You're still into the research mode. Should I not? That's why when the Page of Swords in reverse comes in, it's all for me. Like, it's all talk, no action. Okay? Yeah. This person in your environment, I think this person with the Seven of Cups, now they're confused. Okay, they're confused. I don't see this as someone who's keeping their options open, could be. But I feel now this person is very confused. They just don't like what the fuck just hit them. Because you could have done this very, very abruptly, okay? Because with the High Priestess, it was like it was running on your mind. Your intuition kept screaming, okay, let this go, let this go, let this go. And you probably finally did. And now this person's just waiting and watching of should they make a move towards you or not? Because you're being badass here. You're being really badass. You mentally distanced yourself, okay? From not only this person, but from anything that is bringing inner turmoil, okay? Within you, okay? You don't want to be in the storm anymore. You're releasing yourself is what I'm getting. There's a transition that you're going through right now. And you're okay with it. You're okay with it. You're not stressing about this. But this has brought a lot of confusion to this person, okay? With the Seven of Cups. They just don't know what to do. I'm getting, they don't know how to approach you anymore. That's what I'm getting. And with the Three of Wands here, I feel you're waiting for your ships to come in, or they're waiting for you, okay? They're waiting for you. They're manifesting you. You're manifesting them. But look, we have two manifestation cards here, okay? So it could be two ways. you're manifesting and waiting for your ships to come in because you probably realize that this is the person you want to be with, and if they realize that they really want you, they're going to come towards you, and you have enough faith and hope that this person will come towards you. Or you're manifesting this relationship, you're keeping quiet, you're doing you, and with the Three of Wands, yeah, this person is waiting and watching of if you're going to make a move towards them, or they want to see how to move this forward with, all right? So that's what I have for you, Caps. I hope this reading resonates with you. Let me know in the comments below. Like, share, subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.